money ready. Lock on, lock on, every day. Lock on, Mr. Jinga,
24.
In the place, Galaxy Radio. Yeah, Galaxy Radio. Get it right, yo. Woo! Stay right, yo. Black Radio.
Alright? Vertical vibration, yes, this is the way we do it right here on the Mighty G. As you know, things happen continuously. So, we look, the spirit move, and that's the way we move right here on the Mighty G, your only deep brainwashing station. And right here, right now, just going to make a little, you know, adjustment, you know, to the usual, you know, way we do things within this episode. Right here on the Mighty G. Today we've got here with us, you know, our brother who is going to talk to you about his music, which he's promoting, you know, seeking to bring a message and inspiration to I and I as a people, you know, to move on and keep on keeping on. So we are now going to give our brother the space and the time to introduce himself to you and let him tell you himself who he is. Welcome, my virgin.
Blessed Shangavi. Yeah, man. Deeper than himself, you know? To all of the people over there right now, yeah? African folks, man. Yeah. So, Shanga.
Yes, my brother. The man deeper than.
Yeah,
yes.
Man.
Okay, so, my brother, would you like to tell the people why are you here with Shangavi today?
Why? I'm here to promote the positive word. That's what I'm putting on right now. If you are my black people, then you know, I'm African people, then because you know, say right now we are going through a lot of obstacle with the wazoo with them, you see. So just there, I've been breaking the nose, say, yo, I represent all the African people, then, you know what I mean? Yeah. And I give strength. See back strength from all the cool mother right now. You understand me?
Give thanks, my brother. So the eye is going to play the eye part through the music. Yes, to support the upliftment and the struggle.
And the struggle we have
to get us where we need to get us within this journey.
Yeah, because you know, so the struggle is still on. We still have to fight the struggle because you have some folks out there forget where they're coming from, but me as a man, I keep it real. I never forget. If you forget where you're coming from, you're not going to know where you're going. So you have to keep the positive hope and still fight. You understand me?
Okay, my brother. Well, before we go any further, let us, you know, give the people a little taste of the eye.
Live.
You know?
Yeah.
You know, within the recording feel of the music, I think they have that. I've got a CD out there, yes?
Yeah.
Is it an album or is it a single?
I got a single and I got a few singles and I got an album so far. Name of the album is Defend the Earth.
Alright.
And I got a single which is Wazongo and I'm working on a next single which you're going to play in the show named Driving Black. Because the experience gets pulled over by driving black, so just give me the experience to do this music, you see it?
Okay, my brother. Okay, yeah. Right.
So the first track.
We are gonna give them, is it Wazongo?
Wazongo.
Okay,
yeah.
My brother. So yeah. Let them hear some of that. The man Digo Dan.
I am because we are. Therefore, I am, I represent for all the black man, mad the world. Wazongo, and them no care about we. Wazongo, them no want we have no money. Wazongo, want we live in a poverty. Wazongo, use we black bread against we. Wazongo, and them no care about we. Wazongo, them no want we have no money. Wazongo, want we live in a poverty. Wazongo, use we black bread against we. Fee we gold and rap, fee we diamond. Now them come to Africa, them want to take over the land. True, me come from the Caribbean and them a call me alien. Me no come from space, I mean a robot man. We build them bridges, we build them land.
Yeah, Your only the brainwashing station there is throughout all of Irish, and right here you've got Iman Shanga B, and I've got with me in the
D-Godan
studio live and correct.
Yeah.
Our brother D-Godan, yes, you know, telling you about his music, which is got available for you to have and full joy. Yeah, some inspiring, you know, lyric. And you know, it is good as we support our brother to take it on to another level. Well, we are here and we know that you and you are there, and we rise up once again. We give thanks for your listening company, as it is always welcome to have you aboard while we journey right here on the Mighty G. Song has been inspired,
how this song come about,
what inspired the eye to, you know, bring this song out?
Because right now, expired. We were some rapists, some supermarket, and our black security guard them. They make the white man them, steers them. Look down on the black people and think say, the black people them. Up is no good, you see it. See, you understand me, and more time, that thing that hurt me. So right now we just say, yo, let's put something together and know, say, we are fight the same thing because of what them say. Slavery still on. And some of my black brother them, they're my house rats. You see me, I say. So.
I hear you, my brother. It's a serious thing, you know. I won't say the same thing more or less before they even come in. You know what I mean? Because they, some of our people, they will look out there and look through the master house, and they see a few people, same color like we.
Yes!
And they would say, well, look, see, they see an equal opportunity there. See, everyone have a choice there, you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But not going deeper into the thing to see, you know what I mean, the injustice
of what going on
and the traps that is set to stop I and I from progressing and developing to different levels.
Yeah, but at the same time, the video for this song, do you watch it?
No, I don't have it. I haven't got
it. I think I slept here last night because I uploaded last night on YouTube. And the reason why I put it up on YouTube because it's like, what's going on in the video that's really going on in life? What's going on in the video that's really going on in our life? You understand me? Day by day, our black brother, them beating down them own black brother. You understand me? Fighting against the biting finger against your black brother. You understand me? So right now, I show them, say, yo, was like gonna forget where I come from. So the reason why I do this video now, to show them, say, yo, don't forget, man, the fight is still on. And that's that me. Enough how we forget where I come from. Just show them about big house up, so. And my, you understand me? And my, I live looking better than me and you. Then figure say, oh, I got a house in Kent or I got a house in here, so I'm on top of the world. You're not on top of the world. Cause the white man, them, what's wrong, man, want get rid of your family and their neighborhood. Understand
me? Yeah, it's a serious thing, you know, because they say that is slave traumatic syndrome, you know.
People
lose their memory, people lose their mind.
Lose what they go through.
You understand?
Lose what they go through in life.
No memory.
Forget.
Of their journey, of where they're coming from. You see my deal with it. And I was saying earlier, you know, this is expected, my brother, because, you know, if you look at the farmer principle, for instance, if you have a plant, say, a field of 1,000 whatever plants,
yes.
It's not all going to come true. Some will have to die.
Yes,
some
yes, of course.
Away. Some
yes,
will fade
yes.
away.
No doubt.
Understand?
Yeah.
And you know, the reality of our experience as a people, it is just the fact. Some will forget themselves, forget who they are, forget where they're coming from, forget the experience that they've been through, you know, and go on like it never did exist. You know, and exist in a zombified state.
Yeah, but at the same time, yo, them people that sell out, Reggie.
Well, yes, we have to be very careful of those. We have to be very, very mindful of such, you know.
Because they become lonely, like they are with you.
Definitely.
You understand me? Yeah. And we check them out, they are not. They are Wazungu workers.
Definitely, they are agents.
Agents of Wazungu.
For the enemy.
Yeah, and through all my life, we got through stereotyping. Because a man does look at you and stereotype. You don't even know, you got to read the book before you know the book. Not for these Wazungu, don't read the book. And then you just throw over the book and say, oh, that book, they're ducky.
Well, you know, it is the nature, you know, the behavior of Wazungu, my brother, from time if you're studying. Because anything that does not go with his culture, any culture outside of his culture, is labeled as being backward and, you know, superstition and all these things.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and then he sees himself as the one of that divine authority to, you know, to tell you, you know, or to give you some kind of moral standard of how to go about living your life. You know, hence, the world is in the situation that it is in
today. Really, situation.
It is a situation. And especially we as African people, we are in the worst situation of all situation there is out there.
Yes, I.
So,
there's a lot of situation going on around here.
I hear what the eye said, but let's stay with the music, you know, vibration. Yeah. That's what the eye is here to promote.
Yes.
And to bring that message. Yeah.
But at the same time, we have to teach them the knowledge too, you know.
Most because
enough of all, they don't know the situation.
Right.
Yeah. You see? Yeah. So I have to make them know, you know?
Yes.
Yeah.
So this music now, I mean, we hear the idea, you know, how it was being inspired. Because I see the behavior of our own people towards each other out there.
Yeah.
The behavior of the Wazungu people towards I and I.
Even on the work site.
Mm-hmm.
Most of these work sites, most of our black people fight against our black people and selling out our black own, their own brothers and sisters with the boss. Do they want to be the boss? Coffee go getter. You see, a tea go getter. So they snitch on their own black brother to be on the boss. White, right? White side. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes,
and
yes.
At the end of the day, when the boss use them up and say, oh, if you're busy watching that person, what you really doing? So at the end of the day, the boss get rid of them and they don't know that.
Well, you see, that's a serious thing. You know, because they've been set up against themselves and not knowing that's what's really going on, you know?
Yeah, man. Yeah,
see,
yeah.
It's good that I can at least put some lyrics together to at least give ones and ones an insight of that reality
that is taking
place, you know, among Sinai's appeal.
Yeah, but at the same time, the music here, I got the next music you're gonna play next. The music your name, Driving Black. You know, say one time, about 3 Sunday ago, I was on my way to a market.
All right, then, hold it then. Let's stay with Wazungu for now. When we come to that one,
all right,
we'll go into the details of how it comes to life. Yeah?
All right, Sangami.
So we'll keep on the Wazungu. Yeah, let us get as much
information after Wazungu.
You know, as possible that I can share with you and I about the whole Wazungu vibration.
Yes. Yeah.
Because it's a message. Yes, they are trying to convey to I and I. Out there, yes?
True.
So let us get a fullness of what this message is really about.
True.
You understand?
Yeah.
And at least, you know, in a song, so much can be said in the song. But when you are in person, at least you can give much more and elaborate much more.
For real, about the
song, you know?
Yeah.
So tell us as much as you can tell us about this Wazungu track. Because I think it's a good track, you know, the lyrical mountains of it, you know, is very strong. It's really saying something.
Even the teaching what they give to our kids in the school, them start teach the kids them what they want the kid them to know. They're not teaching.
You see right here, you see this is why we have to brainwash. You see right here on the Mighty G, we born that thinking of ourselves and our children as kids. We born that, we have children.
Children.
You know?
They teach the kids them, the children the wrong thing.
Naturally.
Understand because what? They're not teaching them our black history. Even black schools in this country and America, they teach them what they want them to know. They don't teach them the real teaching of our African people and of our African culture. You understand me?
Definitely.
For instance, they don't teach them about what Wazungu do to us. They don't teach them what Wazungu whip us, put us in cage, treat us like animal.
Mm-hmm.
They don't teach them these things.
Truly?
They just teach them all maths and all these things and their history. You understand me? Because they figure their history are the good history and our history is the bad history. So if I can teach them through my music, that's what I'm gonna do.
Definitely. you know, half of our story has never been told yet, my brother. You know, and we all have a responsibility to fill that gap, you know, where, you know, the missing parts of the puzzle, you know, we need to put it together. And we must always remember and remind ourselves,
yeah,
we owe something to history. Very important. Very, very important.
Yeah, we know that.
We owe something to history.
A lot of us know that.
And that very important aspect, what we as African people owe to history, is to rewrite the wrongs, you know, of history. So we owe history that very important, you know, task to rewrite, yes, the folly, the misinformation.
Fear folly.
So this is why we have to take responsibility to what define for ourselves. We have to study it ourselves. We have to go into the subject, you know, understand what happened yesterday, give us an understanding of where we are today and why what is happening with us today, where we are, my brethren.
Because I don't cut, you know, at the same time we have enough of our area cooked here walking around all day, you know.
Well, we know that, you know,
enough
brethren.
Of us, you know.
But you see, I, man, personally,
I deal with them daily.
I hear that, you know, brother. But you see, I personally, I am looking to progress, to move on. As I said, we know a lot of ones going to be wood for the fire. Yeah. So I'm not here to really focus on those who are not doing anything for the upliftment and the progression of INA within the struggle. Because with me, it's like wasting energy, resources and time. When I could have put out your energy,
resources and time
into taking us, you know, into another step, you know, further into the journey. So, you know, wood for the fire, we make use of that because we need dry wood to keep the fire burning. So we don't put too much energy on those. Well, me personally, I just focus on what I am able to do and what the Spirit gives me, you know, the will to do. And I am determined.
And teach the people there, let's say.
Right here on the mighty G, as you know things happen spontaneously. Right here on the mighty G.
Not plan.
Remember. The ones were looking for the opportunity or for the chance to see, you know, Digo Dan live. Then we have an event will be taking place on the 26th of March.
Yeah.
Digo Dan is going to be there.
Yeah, well,
26th of March.
Put on the spot enough, I will be there.
You see?
I will be there, but it's like a birthday gift for me.
Most
come bless the place.
So if the ones, you know, is looking to see Digo Dan live in action.
Yes, man.
On the 26th of March. Yes, this moon here. Yeah. Saturday, yeah, the 26th, down there at the Martsfield Community Centre, which is at 24 Crochet Road, London, SW9-6FZ. So we will be there and we'll be looking forward
live
to see
direct,
our brother,
so,
you know, Digo Dan.
Come give me the support, right? The people.
Naturally.
Yes.
this English language, as they call it, you know. The language you've got to, you have to listen to it carefully.
And pay attention, you see.
Because, you know, one word
yes.
can mean so many things.
Yes, sir.
You see me? You can be misled. You understand?
One word, show you off, you see it?
You see me?
Yes, I'm going to be a true one.
It seems like we're going to call her here with us. Greetings, Galaxy Radio. Alright. Alright. Okay, my brother. Give thanks. Just keep it locked, yeah?
Sound it.
Yes, my brother, that was my caller say yes, he's, you know, he's tuning right away. And, you know, download the track.
Yes, man, bless
you. Same time.
Not too much. Give thanks. What is his name? Did he leave a name? No?
No, he didn't.
All right, big up Carla. Big up Carla. Respect. Okay. Yes, man.
Yeah. All right, let's see a little bit of it before we talk some more about it.
Yes.
All right.
No. That's Lato.
That's Lato. So what number are we looking for?
Number two, yeah, the track.
Number two.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Yeah.
It's many track, you know. Many track, so we'll filter out the right one then, you know?
Let's give you the right one then now.
Yes.
Driving Black, is it?
Driving Black, yeah.
Mandigo Dan.
Yo, Wani, listen, the boy them behind me, man. Boy, I'm a pull away of a Rasta. I'm a pull away of a Fano. I just pass the boy them up on the corner. And the boy them check out the plate and everything, as I say, everything up to date. I don't know why the boy them want pull away of a Fano, them knows everything is straight. And we not broke no law. We not block the rule. So what is them fool? They must want to go back to school. Sound! Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Mammy sight the bugger them pan the corner. Me bet with one he said them man go pull me over. Me watch them in a me rear view mirror. One, me say 1 minute later. Me pull over to the left of the corner. Police approach me pon the right of the window. It's if you turn off your car, Mr. Driver. Give me your license and your insurance paper. And me say, what's the situation, Mr. Officer? Say me driving too fast in this zone area. Come back up with excuses, Mr. Officer. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Then that thing will really, really hurt me. How when the police them a interrogate me. How immigration them a call up Panway. For self illegal for living in the country. Stereotyping, ya know it fi stop. Say pulling over black, ya know it fi stop. I search up me car, for nothing me no got. I look for the coke, heroin and the crack. No, Rasta man no deal with that. I pay ganja weed, then I we hit top. Tonight, officer me know say you flop. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Give me the real reason you pull me over. Humiliate me, make me turn up on corner. Like me a thief, or me a robber. Not through the color of my skin, Mr. Officer. Me say the racist thing if it over. Me never steal the car, me a the owner. We all equal in a Jaja world, sir. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. Get pulled over by driving black. Can't take no more of the racist cop. True story that happened to me. And when you ride the street, just ride wisely. True story that happened to me. And when you ride the street, just ride wisely. Get pulled over by driving.
Moving on with the vibration, getting black to the usual format right here.